Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss an example in the chapter, example 8.8, the deflection of a falling mass. And because of the Coriolis force, falling objects on the earth are deflected horizontally. For instance, a mass dropped from a tower lands to the east of a plumb line from the release point. In this example, we shall calculate the deflection for a mass m dropped from a tower of height h at the equator. So, the problem is, we have to find the deflection of a mass m dropped from a tower of height h, and the tower is at the equator. So, we have already studied that because of Coriolis force, falling objects on the earth are deflected horizontally. So there is a horizontal deflection of for any object falling to the earth. Now this is due to Coriolis force, Coriolis effect, and the Coriolis force is due to the rotation of the earth, that is rotating. As you all know, so earth is a non-inertial frame, it is rotating. Okay. Here we are considering it is rotating with an angular velocity omega. So this is the picture. This is the portion of earth. Let us take this is eastern side and this is west. This is equatorial plane, this is north. Direction of omega is in this direction, and this is radial direction, and the radial direction can be many. This is the radial direction, and the theta is varying in this direction. So the change in theta is in this direction and towards east. It is take the change in theta, that is theta dot, is in or towards east direction, and the change in the radial direction is in this direction. The change in r will be in this direction. So here is the mass m, and the mass is freely falling to the earth. So we can explain the motion of this particle and the forces acting on this particle. We can take the observer, or we can assume the observer is in this frame, or we can do it with an observer outside the frame. It is more easy to take the observer, or to consider the observer is in the rotating frame. So the observer is in rotating frame and he solves the problem. And in the coordinate system, r theta fixed to the earth with the tangential direction towards the east, the apparent force on m is f rotational is equal to f inertial plus efficacious. So it is better to consider the polar coordinate system to solve this problem, since the we can consider the mass is falling towards earth, it is in radial direction, and the deflection, the horizontal deflection of the falling mass is along theta direction. So it is better to take, it is convenient to take polar coordinates. So I am taking polar coordinates instead of Cartesian coordinate system. So this is the polar coordinate system that we have already studied in the first chapter in the previous semester. So we know that the rotational force, F rotational is equal to F inertial, F inertial plus F efficacious force. And what is F inertial force? F inertial force is nothing but energy, or m in the acceleration, and the acceleration of this particle or of this object is g, which is acceleration due to gravity. team is falling to the Earth's surface. So its direction is minus R direction, and the direction of R is in this direction, and the mass is falling towards this direction. So the direction of F initially is minus R. So we can write it as minus mg R. And what is F fictitious force? F fictitious force is the combination of Coriolis force and velocity of the particle is in the particle. This is the velocity of the particle in rotational frame. The gravitational force, this is the gravitational force at inertia. The gravitational force and the centrifugal force are in radial direction. Radial direction are the forces in radial direction. And if M is dropped from the rust, from a rust point, the Coriolis force in the vectorial plane. So, if mass M is dropped into this equator, so position in the vectorial plane. So, Coriolis force is in the equatorial plane. Coriolis force will be in the equatorial plane. Coriolis force is an equatorial plane. So, thus the motion of M is confined to the equatorial plane. So, the motion of this mass M is confined to the equatorial plane. Since the Coriolis force is in the equatorial plane. Plane and Coriolis force in the so the mass and confined jet in the so we have to find V rotation. We have to find V rotational. We know that V rotational is equal to, it is the velocity in rotational frame, and the expression for the velocity in rotational frame is studied this, which is r dot r cap plus r theta dot theta cap. This is the velocity in polar coordinates. Therefore, F Coriolis is equal to minus 2m omega cross r dot r cap plus r theta dot. So here we want to do the cross product of this term. So it is minus 2m omega cross plus omega cross r theta dot theta cap. And what is omega? It is equal to the magnitude is omega and the direction is z cap. So this is z cap. So the direction direction of omega is in z direction. That's why we have taken r theta z for our coordinates. So while doing the cross product, we will get minus 2m, that is omega cross r dot r dot. So it is omega r dot z cap cross r cap. Is equal to minus 2m omega r dot theta cap plus omega r theta dot minus r cap. So what is omega cross r? This is equal to omega u z cap cross r into r cap. Magnitude of r vector is r, direction is r cap. So it is equal to omega r z cap cross r is theta cap. And how to cross this term with omega? So f centrifugal force is equal to minus m omega z cap cross omega r theta cap is equal to m omega square r r cap. Centrifugal force is m omega square f centrifugal rotational is equal to minus mg r cap minus 2m omega r dot theta cap plus omega r theta dot. Yes. changing the turn like this. We are taking R cap outside. So this is equal to minus mg plus 2m omega R theta dot plus m omega square R. We can write it like this: F rotational is equal to FR radial force plus F theta. m omega r theta dot plus m omega square r theta r cap, and f theta is equal to minus 2m omega r dot theta cap, and we know that the radian equation of a motion is, we have already studied the equation for radial force, which is mass into radial acceleration. We have studied the expression for radial acceleration in the previous first chapter. So FR is equal to m r double dot minus m r theta dot square. First chapter. So m is falling vertically, so this is radial force, and we can write it like this: m r double dot minus m r theta dot square is equal to minus energy plus 2m omega r theta dot plus m omega square r omega square. So m can be get cancelled, and one more approximation is the, we can neglect theta dot, since theta dot is very much less than omega. Omega is a finite quantity, and theta dot is the changing the angle, which is very small quantity. So we can neglect the term containing theta dot. So the equation of motion will become R double dot is equal to minus G plus omega square. This is equation number 5, and the tangential equation of motion, this is the radial equation of motion, R dot is equal to G plus omega square R, and the tangential equation of motion is, we know that the tangential acceleration A theta is equal to R theta double dot plus 2 R dot theta dot. The theta cap. So m r theta double dot plus 2m r theta dot r dot theta dot is equal to minus 2m r dot omega. This is the term from the equation approximational. This is the tangential tangential force, and this is the expression for tangential force using polar coordinates. A theta is A theta is equal to r theta double dot plus 2 r dot theta. So r theta double dot is equal to 2 r dot omega. We can neglect theta dot since theta dot is very much less than omega. So the equation of motion in the tangential direction is r theta double dot is equal to 2 r dot omega. Put this equation, because this equation no problem. So during the fall r changes only slightly. So we are taking the radius of earth is r, taking the radius of earth is r. So the tower height is h. So compared to r, h can be neglected, or we can write re plus h to r. H can be neglected when comparing these two quantities. We can write re plus h is approximately equal to re, and re is the radius of earth, and taking g is constant. Equation number 5 is r double dot is equal to minus g t plus omega square r. This equation number 5 is g plus omega square. So g plus omega square r. And we can write r double dot is equal to minus g prime, where g prime is equal to g minus omega square. Omega square r is g minus omega square r. G prime is equal to, and g prime g minus r square omega square r. The acceleration due to gravitational force minus centrifugal tug. Centrifugal tug. And therefore g prime is an apparent acceleration due to gravity, and since this is customarily denoted by g. So g prime is an apparent acceleration due to gravity. So we can drop the prime here. We can write g prime is equal to g. Therefore, the equation of motion will become r double dot is equal to minus g, and we can find r dot is equal to minus g t, and r is equal to the constant equation of 0 minus half g is. Dot in the equation 6. What is equation number 6? Equation number 6 is, okay, we have a number here, the value of r. towards the mass m will deflect it towards this. So it is an interesting problem, and if you have any doubts in this,